Hello everyone, I'm Silvia Fernandez Colorado from Puerto Rico, and some people know me as Dr. Soul. You can find more information about me on my if you subscribe to my channel or check out other videos. But today I want to talk about, someone asked me, why do some people choose, or why do they get negative thoughts first or before they get the positive thoughts, more than the positive thoughts coming in like more naturally? And the way I see it is that our parents love us so much in most cases, or in all cases, that they don't want to lose us. So when we're little, they're always telling us what to watch out for. Watch out for bad people. Be careful with this. Don't do that. You should do this. Be careful about that. You should watch out for those kind of people, for those kind of experiences. I haven't heard that many parents saying, you're gonna love being an adult. It's amazing. Life is great. You're gonna love this universe. You're gonna love this earth. Everything is so beautiful. You know, how many parents do you hear saying that to their children? Not so many, right? So I believe that being scared about life, or being afraid to die, being afraid to get sick, it all comes with what we learn from society. I believe there should be some cultures when it's not, the negative thoughts are not so bad. I believe there are some cultures that embrace more the cycle of life and the cycle of how we're always expanding and changing and growing. So I believe that when you want to feel better, the thing to do is find thoughts to help you feel better. For example, if something is hurting in your body, instead of telling the whole world through Facebook, through your phone calls with your friends, your chats with your neighbors, don't tell everybody about it if they can't do something about it, other than feel sorry for you. Feeling sorry for you might help you for a little bit, but in the long run, it only keeps you feeling that way. So my view of life is trying to always find a good and positive outlook on things. So if this eye is hurting, then focus on this one. If you're having a bad day because something happened, that it already happened and you went through it and you overcame it and there's nothing to do about it anymore, then don't say it to everybody. Don't post it on your Facebook. Try to post more positive things. And it's interesting that somebody asked me about this in English, because I posted earlier today something in Spanish talking about the what if exercise. And this what if exercise is from Abraham Hicks. And they talk about, because mostly people say, what if this gets worse? What if my body this, and it's something bad? What if the family, if this happens to the family? And usually the what ifs are going towards the negative. So the exercise that I shared in Spanish, and I would like to share it with you in English now, my English speaking friends, is that you find the notebook, and you could do it either in the morning, in the afternoon, whenever is better for you. It's just good to pick one time, preferably, so that you kind of make it a habit, that you write down. I always say write it down. For many reasons, it's better to write it down than to just think about it or tell somebody. Write it down and then tell somebody. What if, do this exercise, you can do it on Facebook for those of you that like posting stuff on Facebook. What if we can learn something from this situation? What if my family gets closer? What if my community learns how to embrace situations in a better way? What if I start eating healthier? What if this staying at home time brings me new ideas of looking at life? What if I find some stuff on YouTube or in the internet for free that can help me learn about this or that I was wanting to have more time to do? What if I try something new? The other day, this guy was taking a soul alignment meeting with me, and he's like, Sylvia, I just want to take all my hair off. I just want to shave it off. And I was like, do it. This is the time. Why? Because I believe this is an option. This is a time for you to try new things. I tried a new hair color. Caroline, look at my new hair color. I'm waiting for your blonde. So yes, try something new. Try something new. It doesn't matter. You don't need to explain to people. You just try it out. Something, it can be a hair color, it can be a new exercise, it can be a new meditation, it can be a new job. It can be many things. So try it out. Learn something fun every day. Look for fun things instead of looking for how to solve this problem, how to have more fun in my life, how to enjoy life a little bit better with my grown-up kids, how to find love in my life, how to appreciate life more. Find good things and good feeling thoughts. And when you have a glass of dirty water, for example, and you want clean water, you could either, if it's a bucket of dirty water and it's too heavy and you can bring it up and pull it over, or you can pour clean water in there until all the dirty water is out. So the way I see it, when you pour clean thoughts into your mind all the time and you keep pouring and pouring and pouring what ifs that are positive, then the negatives won't come out as often. And when they do, you recognize them. And instead of saying, go away, you can say, okay, I caught you. Now I know what I want. And I want this. Yes, I want this. And yes, I want.